close that.
Move the gate. Right here?
No, you're gonna move that. No, move the camera back. Oh, there's your brother's bowl. Jazz.
That?
Yeah, but turn that. No. Yeah. And
you need like
my hands in
front.
Okay. So hi guys. I'm not streaming and this will be posted on YouTube. I wanted to tell you guys life with Sjogren's. For those that don't know what Sjogren's is, it is a autoimmune disorder that attacks your mucous glands, systemic disease. So basically, it affects everything. I'm actually going to take you guys to the Sjogren's Foundation website. Just give me a sec because I did not think of this.
Thank you for coffee. Sorry.
New window. So I have fibromyalgia and Sjogren's syndrome. So I can get the flares, which is what I'm having right now. I actually have to have my daughter help me find my cane, which is right here, so I could get out of bed this morning. And I, as much as I wanted to stay in bed, I have to work, or prepare for work, so I have to do my tests and stuff for work while still going through my joints swelling and the pain, and it's wonderful. I will not be surprised if today or tomorrow I end up with fiber fog. Typically happens. So, let's do this. Sjogren's Foundation. Sjogren's Syndrome. Sjogren's Foundation. And then OPS. And paste. Yeah, that's working now. Okay. Cool. Okay. Got a lot to edit out right there. So yeah, I can't get the COVID vaccine. Thanks. Okay, so systemic diseases affecting the entire body. Yeah, I've been dealing with this for a long time. I got officially diagnosed at Jasmine was 3.
So,
Jasmine was 3 when they were trying to figure it out, and they were trying to figure it out for a year. So officially diagnosed when Jasmine was 4. So 12 years ago. Anyway, Jasmine, so 12 years ago, and I'm 39 now. So 27 when I was officially diagnosed. And it started out with, I was holding Jasmine on my, I was like this, carrying Jasmine, she was asleep. And she wasn't very heavy at the time. She was, what, 25 pounds? Because she's got her own health stuff that was causing her to be smaller than what she should have been. And then I felt this branch breaking feeling in my arms. Like, if you take the sound of branches breaking and turn that into a pain, splintering, that would be the explanation that I have for it. It's a splintering pain. And it's all over. But this started in my arms. And for 2 days, I couldn't figure out why my arms were still hurting. It's like, okay, like, what's going on? Well, they tested me for everything. They were like, did you get your vaccines when you were a baby? I was like, yeah, my parents made sure. I'll get back to that in a second. They tested me for everything. Then they sent me to another doctor. That doctor was trying to figure everything out. And they were like, okay, it's vitamin D deficiency. Well, I live in Alaska. It's typical for Alaskans to have low vitamin D. I was on 40,000 IU a week. And then we tried the more processed stuff so it'll be easier for my body to process. 40,000 IU a week. And that didn't work. And then, so I'm supposed to be taking vitamin D every day. And it's not, that's not a thing. There's all this stuff that's going on. And they're trying to figure it out. They're doing blood tests every week. They're, drawing blood, trying to figure out what's going on. And the only consistent thing is that my ANA keeps showing positive. Like, all the time, my ANA is showing positive, positive, positive. And they're not sure what's going on. So finally, after a year, they pull out a rheumatologist. And she's like, do you have dry eyes? Yeah. All the time. They're itchy. All the time. Stop it. It's just the gas truck. Stop it. Go lay down. And she's like, well, dry mouth? Yeah. All the time. Even if I drink water, it's still dry. And I don't like water. I don't. They diagnosed me with fibromyalgia and Sjogren syndrome. After looking at all my tests, after looking at all my chart notes and everything. So the Sjogren's part is the part that's attacking my mucous glands, making it to where I have no lubrication, little to no lubrication in my joints.
Or your vagina. You gotta bring that up.
I gotta bring up my vagina. Okay. George wants me to make sure that y'all understand that everywhere that has moisture, including, parts, they get dry too. I cannot be sexually active for very long because it hurts otherwise. Like, I'm not complaining though.
Naughty.
So I've got widespread body pain from the Sjogren's. And then I've got widespread body pain from the fibromyalgia. Fibromyalgia is the nerve pain. That's the ones that are like, the nerve endings are freaking the fuck out. A lot of people get debilitating pain with that. I don't. The part with the Sjogren, the fibro that kills me is when I get my fibro fog and, it can hit at any time, which sucks because I don't know when it's going to hit, but I can feel it coming. It's like a, on the back of my tongue. It feels like pins and needles, and it feels like my tongue gets really big. Go! I love you, puppies. I do. Go, please. Out. Out. Out.
Did he hide comments?
I don't know. So...
that fucking asshole.
I get that sometimes, and it actually happened last year while I was working at the tutor location for my job, and so for an hour, I got to do just...
Leia, shut it. Go in your room.
I couldn't actually help clients for that 1 hour. I had to do just straight up CSA work because I was not useful and I couldn't drive home. Because the first time I ever noticed the fiber fog was when I was driving and my mom was with me. This was back when I was like 29, 30. I was taking mom somewhere. And I had, we had stopped at a red light. And I could have sworn the light turned green. And I started to go. My mom's like, hey, that's a red light. And I freaking slammed on my brakes. And I was like, I thought that was green. I don't know what's going on. I made it home safe the rest of the way. But I don't drive when I'm having a fiber fog flare up. But... out! Right now... this is... my hands. You guys can't really see anything right now, but it feels like there's liquid in between my joints. Typically it's in my elbows, and this shoulder has had surgery on it twice. This is the first Sjogren's flare I've had since this second surgery, and this shoulder is completely screaming at me, saying, "Bitch!" It hurts. So yeah, it sucks. I decided to do this vlog because A, I can't stream. And B, I can edit it for when interruptions happen or I get loud because I'm yelling at kids or dogs or whatever. But I wanted to show you guys what it's like, and I wanted to show that there are people out there that are dealing with this, and it's getting more information out there. It can happen at a young age even. There's, okay, so that's how you pronounce it, and that's how you spell it. Sjogren's. And it's S-J-O with the two dots, G-R-E-N, apostrophe S. Living with Sjogren's. Yeah, it sucks. I've had this for 12 years, and it sucks. I've probably had it for longer, but it was just diagnosed. There is actually... cases out there where children are being diagnosed with this, and it's out. It's it's not really easy to diagnose in the first place. But let's see if I can find that post. I'm gonna go ahead and switch to my main camera right now so I can have it full screen. So this is on the Sjogren's Foundation Facebook page. And I don't want other people's comments or names out there because it's, sorry, it may be on a public page, but not mine. So, symptoms in children are fatigue, joint pain, muscle pain, arthritis, and swollen, painful salivary glands, which, thinking back on it, these are things I had as a child. It felt like underneath my tongue was burning all the time. Like, it was painful, and I'd always tell my mom, my mouth hurt. But back then, back in the 80s, nobody knew. And it's been diagnosed in older generations. When I was 27, at the time, it was unheard of for younger generations to have it. So for now to come out that even children can have this, maybe we can get more information out there. Maybe we can get more research done. I've always told my husband, and I'm actually looking into it with the Sjogren's Foundation. I want to donate my body to the Sjogren's Foundation to find a cure. Because honestly, this sucks. Either want a cure or more treatment options, because I cannot even... Hold. I am so sorry. What is my husband doing right now? What are you doing right now? But yes, I woke up and I knew that the pain was there, and it just kept getting worse, and I had to call Jasmine on Discord to help me out of bed, because I didn't know where my cane was, and yeah, George was still sleeping. I actually woke him up calling Jasmine to come find my cane, which was at the foot of my bed somewhere. But yeah, this is all stuff that I didn't notice, or I noticed, but it didn't actually click. So, use that. Like, definitely figure that one out, because this is painful. It's so painful. Spread awareness. I don't want to give or not. Okay, so there's really no treatment options for this. This is just... Yeah, okay, so my eye doctor got really mad when I didn't go see him after I got diagnosed with Sjogren's. He's like, you should be coming to see me more often. So the Scrimmer test... They take this card with a piece of paper or something on it. It's like this little thing. They stick it in this part of your eye. Let me bring up my camera better. Okay. Oh, man. Come on, browser. Really? Really, I hate you right now. I was trying to make this big. Oh, there. I can actually see it, though. So, they take this little piece of paper and stick it in the corner of your eye. And they do this for both eyes. And they test how much tear production you have. And mine has always been severe. In both eyes. I have little to no tear production. My cells are actually being ripped away every time I blink. I'm supposed to be taking eye drops, but it burns, so I don't. And the reason why it's burning is because my cells are not regenerating fast enough, and I'm ripping the old cells before the new cells can even regenerate. So it's leaving holes, pretty much. Which is why eye drops burn. It sucks. And I've talked to my eye doctor about the burning, and I've talked to him about doing something else, because I can't take eye drops, because it just hurts so fucking much. Like, it makes me cry, which crying in Sjogren's is actually not a good thing, because you're actually drying your eyes out some more. You're not actually using your tears. The way he explained explain it. It's really weird. But I do know that crying is a bad thing. Yeah, lysamine green is how they figured out that I've got cell damage. My dentist. Let's see. My dentist. I have not gotten a salivary gland biopsy. I have had all four of my wisdom teeth removed, and then two of my molars removed. And there's a possibility that I'm going to have more removed, because no matter how much I brush, I have no saliva to keep my teeth, you know, your saliva is a way to keep your teeth clean between brushing. I don't have saliva. So it's either I'm going to be brushing all day every day, or I just say fuck it. And basically that's what I'm going to say, fuck it. I will brush my teeth. I'll brush my teeth. I just don't do it all the time. And because, again, it hurts. And I was going to my dentist every 3 months instead of six. And the Medicaid was like, no, that's too much. We're not paying for it, so. Same with my eye doctor. 3 months instead of every six. I also have visual field loss in both eyes. And I haven't been able to ask if that's a side effect of the no tears thing, or if I'm just, what they call me is pre-glaucoma. I'm on glaucoma watch is what it is. So there's a possibility at some point I'll go completely blind. Not fun. Yeah, these are questions that they did ask, and that's how I got diagnosed. So another thing about your sexual organs is, not only is that part dry, but in women, and I didn't know this until I got pregnant with my second child, Sjogren syndrome can cause congenital heart block in newborns, which means their heart can not form correctly. And so we found out with Zoe that she had a murmur. And then when she was born, they found something else. I walked into the NICU and they were doing a heart test, some kind of test on her, and I can't remember what it was at that point. But she had a heart doctor for 4 months. Luckily, she didn't have to have any surgeries or anything, but she had a pediatric heart doctor for 4 months of her life. Congenital being born with, or born, or formed before, or whatever. But yeah, it can cause congenital heart block. Luckily, with all three of my kids, I got lucky and they didn't have it. With Eric, we went to the MFM, and she's like, his heart's fine, his kidneys are small. Then we went in the second time, his kidneys are good, your cervix is short. So I had to end up in the hospital for 72 days, but that was worth it. I'm just glad that my kids did not end up with congenital heart block, and that's one of the reasons why I was like, nope, I'm done with kids. Take out my tubes, please. Because I couldn't put myself through that again. The stress of not knowing if my kids were going to be okay. My body couldn't handle it anyway because I was sick all the time. I had severe hyperemesis, which I'm not sure if that's also part of the Sjogren's. Like, there's a whole bunch of stuff that I don't know that could be part of Sjogren's, but could not be. And nobody can give me answers. My rheumatologist dropped me when Zoe was two or three. Because the first time I missed my appointment, I was in a car accident. No, the first time was, I can't remember what was going on. The second time, I was in a car accident, and the third time, Zoe's appointment ran over, and their elevator was slow as shit. So I was 5 minutes late because of a stupid elevator. It was in the elevator, in the building. And they were like, nope, he's not going to see you. So, and being that I live in Alaska, and I lived in Anchorage at the time, there's only so many doctors that'll see certain patients. Like, I guess there was one rheumatologist on base, one rheumatologist at the Native Hospital, and one rheumatologist for regular people. This doctor, there's another doctor that works in that office. This doctor that had me was the lead at the hospital that I was at. I cannot see the other doctor because my doctor said no. I now live in Fairbanks. I don't live in Anchorage anymore. I don't know if that's against the law or whatever, what he did, but, you know. I got dropped, so my stuff has been unchecked. Any medications that we did try weren't working anyway. We've tried, like, they were either not working at all, didn't work and side effects were bad, or, didn't, or worked and the side effects were too damaging, or too great. I got mean on the one that worked for my pain, but, yeah. You can ask my husband. I was not a nice person, and he's the one that told my doctor, no. She's changed. I did a personality flop, pretty much 180. I was not nice to my husband or people that I was normally nice to. Of course, Jordan and I were dating at the time. This is way before him and I got married. But yeah, it was bad. It wasn't working. Yeah, at first they thought I had lupus. Which wasn't the case. And so yeah, it's Sjogren's is a rare condition. It's not easy to diagnose because of other symptoms, as you can read right there. Do I have that still up though? Yeah, I do. Okay. And the fact that it's not, but it can cause other things. I'm trying to find. There's clinical trials?
Oh, shit.
There's Sjogren's. Oh. I completely spaced that Sjogren's was typically found in women. But apparently it's found in men, too. But, yeah, it's... That's cool. So yeah, I'm at right now, I'm having pain all over, especially in my shoulder right now, and my ankles and my joints, my fingers and my toes, and my spine. I had George rub my spine earlier because it hurts. Yeah, it hurts a lot. I try not to walk on this. And I had to get up because I still have my testing to do for my work and all that. So while I have all this going on, I don't know. I have blood clots on top of everything, and they are telling me that the blood clots are due to my Sjogren's. That's what my vascular person said. My husband has my jack pillow. that the Sjogren's disease, because of the lack of mucus, that there's a possibility that I'm having the clots more often and not knowing why is because of the fact that I have Sjogren's disease. So I'm more susceptible to them, apparently. But I don't have a clotting factor. I don't have, like, factor 5 or factor 8 or anything. I don't have that specific piece that they thought that maybe that was the cause. No, it's just my Sjogren's syndrome being my Sjogren's syndrome. So I've got a lot of stuff going on because of this one disease that is invisible. So when I'm limping or with walking with a cane, I get looked at funny because, you know, I'm a 39-year-old woman and yesterday I was fine. Because yesterday I was. I felt fine. I mean, I'm in constant pain 24/7, but there are days like today where it just... it flares up and it's worse than it was yesterday. I can't. There are days where it's going to be worse than this and I won't be able to function. There are days where it's going to feel like, wait, what Sjogren's? What pain? Because, you know, this is my life with Sjogren's. It's my cane that's sitting in the house and everybody's like, why is your cane here? It's for days like today when I can't walk or I can't get out of bed and I have to have help to get around my house. It's the... it's me being on CBD because I'm in constant pain and I just want a relief. The edibles aren't doing what I need them to do anymore. I'm getting anxiety when I eat them now. No matter how low I go on doses, I still get anxiety. So I'm switching to CBD as soon as I can. Can't do that yet because I need a job to actually pay for it. My job needs to hurry up and do its job. Hear me? Yeah. So I'm going to start a My Life with Sjogren's blog. It's not going to be an everyday thing. It's not going to be an all the time thing because, like I said, I don't have to deal with it all the time. I do, but I don't. Like, my flares are not all the time. My dry eyes and dry mouth are all the time. My widespread body pain is all the time. But I can still walk on those days. I am going to start blogging a lot more. And putting it on YouTube. Because that's the only place I can put it. So, if you come here from just searching, let me know in comments. Or if you're dealing with Sjogren's yourself, let me know your experiences. Because I have not met anybody besides the people in a group that I was a part of for like 5 minutes. And then I made a joke and I got kicked because I made the joke. Apparently they didn't like that. I made a joke about a calendar 5 years ago. I got booted from a group for it because, I mean, who doesn't like hot firefighters? Just saying. And I got kicked from the group.
I don't
And you don't like hot firefighters?
No.
Okay. Good to know. But yeah, so I got kicked from that group. It was great. I was like, what for? And they were like, we don't joke like that. What, you don't see a hot firefighter in drool?
No, I don't.
Apparently, no, she don't either. So, I really have no one else I can bounce this stuff off of. So now, bounce it off of y'all. So yeah, if you have Sjogren's, let me know. If you were recently diagnosed, get a rheumatologist, a good one, a good rheumatologist. Not one that's going to screw you over. It can cause other things. It affects everything. In fact, I can actually find the... There's another picture somewhere that I can look for on the Sjogren's website. It's got the... And I'll be sharing this stuff to my Facebook as well. I've already shared quite a bit of it to my Facebook, but I can also put it on my Twitter. Yeah, so there's the Sjogren's Fund. Damn it. My bad. Sorry. If you're wondering why I keep putting the main camera on before I move to the photo, it's because if there's comments on the photo itself from the Sjogren's Foundation, I do not want those comments to be on my YouTube channel. Yeah, so neurological problems, concentration, memory loss, headaches, dystonomia, no idea what that is. Dystonomia, dry eyes, corneal ulcerations and infections, dry nose, recurrent sinusitis, nosebleeds. I have had sinusitis and my nose is constantly dry. I barely have to blow my nose. Dental decay is a major thing. I still get the pain in my salivary glands, difficulty swallowing, heartburn I get a lot. Fatigue is a major thing. Vasculitis, if that's got something to do with the... Vasculitis, does that have anything to do with the blood clots, honey?
What?
Vasculitis. What is that?
Inflammation of your...
veins and shit?
Yeah.
Oh. Recurrent bronchitis and interstitial lung disease and pneumonia. I have asthma, so... muscle pain, definitely. These are just things that can come up. There it is, vaginal dryness. Oh, and men can have chronic prostatitis. That sucks. Shit. Yeah, Yeah, so if I hadn't been diagnosed by now, this is about the time that I would have been diagnosed, because the average age of Sjogren's diagnosis is 40 years, but it can occur in all age groups. So if you are experiencing a lot of these symptoms, like the dry nose, dry mouth, and painful salivary glands, dry eyes, and muscle pain, those are factors saying, hey, something's wrong. Go get seen. Go talk to your primary and ask for, tell them what's going on and ask for a referral to a rheumatologist, because this shit sucks. And the fact that Sjogren's can cause cancer? Yeah. I quit smoking 2 weeks ago? 2 weeks ago or a week ago?
It's been a while.
I quit smoking because, well, because I needed to quit, but also because I don't want to put myself out there to end up hurting anymore. Where is that picture? Where'd it go? There is a picture. It's got... did I share it on my page? I think I shared it on mine. I know it's not Children's Awareness Month, but yeah, this is... Hey guys. What I wouldn't give for a cure for Sjogren's, because honestly, it hurts a lot. So, I can't find it. That's great. Unless it was... No, I don't know where it would be. That's weird. Okay. There used to be a picture that had, basically the human body and all the insides, and it pointed to each one saying what could happen or what could present and all that. So yeah, it's a widespread, it affects everything and it sucks. But yeah, so I hope this was kind of educational, maybe. Like I said, if you have Sjogren's, or if you know somebody who has Sjogren's, or if you just wanted to know about Sjogren's and rare diseases, yeah, comment, like, you can subscribe. I'm actually going to be starting to put more videos up on my YouTube. I'm going to be doing gameplay videos and posting them, because I can't stream right now. I'm a Twitch streamer and I can't stream, so this is one way that I'll be able to do this. But let me know in comments if you guys would like to know more, or updates on how I'm doing and everything like that. This may be my only Life with Sjogren's video, but it, who knows? I can't tell the future.
You guys have a good day.